Hi there, welcome to the last of our Lockdown Diaries. So today, Wednesday, the lockdown is ending. So we will be doing our final rundown. This final video will actually be partially recorded on the Wednesday and also on the Thursday after lockdown, because I'm a little bit behind. So you'll see one of my mates here with me that will be after lockdown enjoying a bit of music. So don't be too up in arms about us breaking the lockdown on that one. So what I'm going to do from here on in is I'm going to be just doing a regular video, but it'll give it a different name. So it won't be Lockdown Diaries, it'll be Life After Lockdown. And we'll still show some new gear. We'll feature same sort of things, but probably more of a focus on new gear and actually looking at particular gear and systems. We've covered off a lot of the queries that we've had. We have had a couple of suggestions from subscribers, like to do one between the difference between tube amps and solid state. So we'll certainly look at that. That's something that is close to my heart, as you'd probably know. And we'll also feature some of those other things that we've been doing, like the excerpts from the TAS archives, and also some of my stories from the past 47 years of my hi-fi journey. So there'll be plenty to have a look at, but I'll be doing them on a weekly basis. So one a week, and I'll try to get them out on either a Friday or a Saturday. So it'll be towards the end of the week, give you something to look at over the weekend. So today, just a little bit of an expansion to what we've talked about in the past about power and so forth. A lot of people have sort of got the idea that if you've got a 100-watt speakers, you need a 100-watt amplifier, or that a big amplifier is going to blow your speakers if it's rated more than the power of your speakers. Well, my experience has been that big amplifiers that are loafing along will not tend to kill even quite small, modestly priced speakers, because they will just be putting out such clean power that you will know when the speakers are running out of steam. They'll sound distressed, but they won't get killed. The reverse is that if you use a small amplifier and it is struggling like crazy and clipping, it can kill even very expensive speakers that might be rated way beyond the power of the amplifier. So if you're in doubt as to whether an amplifier is going to suit your speakers, it's always better to go with a bigger amplifier than what the speakers are rated for, rather than the other way around. It's much safer. You'll also get a better quality of sound. Now, I've heard a lot of so-called experts talking about how the quality of your speakers is the most important thing in your system, and you'll know that I disagree with that quite intensely. I've heard a lot of very nice sounding systems where the speakers were the cheapest part of the system because they were feeding a phenomenally good sound into their system, and therefore the speakers just got a great sound fed into them. How much could they leave out? And we see that all the time when we put, say, a pair of Magnepaners that are maybe $3,000-$4,000 speakers, and we put a $20,000 front end into a $20,000 amplifier, and these little speakers that are like $3,000-$4,000 just come alive and just sound so much bigger than what you would think. And then you put a subwoofer on them and you flesh them out down into the bass, and they take on another scale and sound way beyond what the price would indicate. Now, I've heard $60,000, $70,000, $100,000 speakers that don't sound any better than those Maggies with a couple of REL subs on them at a fraction of that cost. So, something food for thought. So I'm going to give you a listen to the Maggies, some of the music that we've been listening to. There'll be some very short excerpts of music, so I won't play the full tracks most of the time, just to keep our video within a reasonable time frame. So let's get and listen to some music.
Thank you.
So a bit of Suzanne Vega from 87.
I'm not afraid to die.